Welcome as the NCAA Women's Championship is brought to you by Capital One. We say hello to you from blistering Bristol. I'm Elle Duncan, your host. We're joined by our national champion and Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo, former LSU head coach turned president of the Las Vegas Aces of the WNBA, Nikki Fargus. All right, let's get you some updates as we get you set for NC State. You are going to see that action any minute from now, but UConn happening right now over on ABC. 2-seed UConn taking on 15-seed Mercer. And we take a look here, and I know, Rebecca, that one of the most important things for Gino Auriemma was emphasizing a hot start. How did they do?
Well, Connecticut was doing well on the offensive end of the floor, getting offensive rebounds, but where they were really impressive to me was defensively, limiting what Mercer wanted to do, getting out into passing lanes and having that lead to transition buckets the other way.
Well, the other thing that you see is a balanced attack. I think the one thing that UConn is doing is they are clicking on all cylinders, but the fact that they were overextending their defense to pick up on the full court, to me, that's a UConn that's healthy, that's fresh and ready to compete.
All right, so there you go. Right now, they are in firm control of Mercer. Again, this is a team that on average beats their first-round opponents by 40 games, so Mercer certainly hanging in there. Also, right now, happening in action, BYU and Nova in a 6-11 matchup. We've got to say, for Maddie Segrist, it's been pretty much quiet night, but what are you seeing in this matchup?
Well, BYU came out strong in this game. They had an 11-point lead in the first quarter, and then Villanova was able to get BYU to turn over the basketball. They were able to score off of that, and the supporting cast for Maddie Segrist and Villanova has performed well so far.
Well, and the other thing that BYU, you look at the game is played in a game of runs. And so when you're able to go on a 7-0 run, that gave them that separation they needed. But Villanova is a team that's going to stay in it to the end.
We take a look at the Wichita region, and again, the winner of BYU-Villanova is going to play Michigan or American University in second round action. That's a game that you're going to see a little later today on ESPN2. At 3:30. Let's take a look at the Bridgeport region, K-State, Washington State, all the states. This wasn't the prettiest game of all time, Rebecca, but what'd you see here between Kansas State and Washington State?
Well, you saw a team that offensively they were struggling, but when you have a player like Ayoka Lee, you have got to get her touches. You got to figure out how to get her the basketball. And she played 39 minutes, 20 points, 15 rebounds. But as you can see, Kansas State turned up their defense, holding Washington State to 40 points.
I say it was sort of ugly. We went almost 4 minutes at the end of this game without a single field goal from either team. But alas, Kansas State wins, and they move on. Also in action, Indiana and Charlotte. Early first quarter, it's Mackenzie Holmes finding Alexa Goulbe for the three.
Yeah, and Indiana has a nice balance attack on the offensive end of the floor, and that's important in this game because Mackenzie Holmes has not played in the second quarter, picked up two fouls, but there's just going to be too much from her teammates for Indiana.
Right now, 33-15, Indiana up on Charlotte. NC State, we mentioned it, the heartbreak a year ago, the upset loss in the Sweet 16. Why is this team better prepared to make a longer run?
Well, when you lose the previous year, it's a motivating factor for the following season. They were upset by Indiana. This is a team that has tremendous experience. They have graduate students, senior-led team, and they're motivated, and they're playing their best basketball of the season right now.
Guard play. I'm gonna keep saying that. Perez and Johnson, they have got to perform. Kunane has done a phenomenal job of being the steady person that you have inside, so they've got to come to play as well.
Alyssa Kunane hurt in the ACC championship. The good news for the Wolfpack fans is that she appears to be healthy and ready to go. And so are we. Tip when we come back from Raleigh with Sam Ravage and Kelly Gramblich. Thanks for watching.
Capital One. Madness rolls on here in Raleigh, North Carolina, as the host and number one seed NC State face off against the 16 seed Longwood Lancers. NC State earned the number one seed for the second straight season, looking to make a deep run this year. Winner of this one will advance to the second round in a meeting with Kansas State, who just took care of business against Washington State moments ago. K-State's Ayoka Lee had just 6 points in the first half, ended up with a team-leading 20 points. The second-team All-American caused problems down the stretch, and K-State on their way to a second-round matchup with the winner of this game on Monday. was just terrific in that game. A double-double, her 20th of the season. Take a look at our bracket here in the Bridgeport region. Yes, NC State, the number one seed, will face off against K-State on Monday. As we welcome you courtside, alongside Kelly Gramlich, I am Sam Ravitch. It is a pleasure to have you with us. And Kelly, that was an exciting matchup that we saw, and Aoka Lee was great in that first game.
We saw a very closely contested 8-9 game. In the end, Aoka Lee was too much for Washington State.
All right, so this 16 seed Longwood is in their first NCAA tournament in program history. Akilah Smith has been the key for them. She put up 32 points and 13 boards in the first four games to get them to this point. She is the Adidas achieving the impossible.
She truly is the Big South Player of the Year. She was unstoppable in the first four games against Mount St. Mary's. 32 points, 13 rebounds. She dominated inside. She was truly able to score at will. I am very intrigued to see how NC State guards her in this game. As we said, a 30-burger for Akilah Smith, just one of four players so far in the NCAA tournament that has scored over 30 points.
A sold-out Reynolds Coliseum, KG, and we are underway. Sea of red here for this 16-1 matchup. Take a look at our starting lineups brought to you by Capital One here today. Longwood starting five. Kyla McMakin with the first shot of the game. One of the leading scorers for this team. You got three players on Longwood averaging double digits. What's going to be the key for NC State here early on against a Longwood team who has already played in this tournament, Kelly?
The key is knowing where Akilah Smith is at all times. I'm very interested to see, with right now Elisa Cunane is guarding her, can Akilah Smith take advantage of that, use her speed and her quickness to get around Cunane?
Kennedy Calhoun got the rebound off the air ball, and Longwood will reset here. Hand off to Tredasia Smith. She averages over five assists a game. McMakin, another three, count it! And Longwood is on the board first here.
McMakin picks up where she left off in the first four. Makin threes, that's what she does, Sam.
She was 4 for 5 from beyond the arc in the first four game. Here is Reyna Perez, the mid-range jumper. So smooth for the graduate player from Goodyear, Arizona.
Smooth is the word. That's how I would describe Reyna Perez's game. She never looks rattled. She never looks frustrated. She is a fifth-year senior and one of the leaders of this team at the point guard position.
Second straight tournament for NC State as the one seed. A disappointing finish last year in the Sweet 16. Looking to make a deeper run this year. Got to get past Longwood first. Kennedy Calhoun's three is no good. So already four threes in the game taken by Longwood. Reyna Perez, mid-range on the other side this time. First 4 points of the game to Reyna Perez in the pack.
Reyna Perez putting on a show in the mid-range so far for the pack.
Akilah Smith shot blocked at the rim. Cunane distributes to Perez. Hesitation, back to Cunane. Kai Crutchfield now from the elbow. Pull up off the top of the backboard. And whistle underneath. Foul goes against Kennedy Calhoun. All right, Wes Moore has done a fantastic job. Ninth season, ACC Coach of the Year. Look, when you think about this NC State program, Wes Moore is just kind of that right fit. He's a player's coach, and he's brought this team to back-to-back number one seeds in the tournament.
He is a great fit, and he's put together an experienced and very talented roster. He hasn't been able to get some of those top 10, top 20 recruits, but it doesn't matter because he's put together a roster that fits so well together, and NC State's depth will be on display today. They will go eight deep. They'll bring three off the bench. All three players they bring off the bench, Boyd and Javi and Diamond Johnson, could start almost anywhere else in the country.
Cunane makes both at the line. We talk about NC State trying to make a deeper run this season. That was not a luxury that they necessarily had last year, was depth off the bench. And now this year they do. Backdoor cut, nice move by McMakin, up and in for two.
We said this, if you watched our first four game on Thursday night, and I said this probably six times, Sam, McMakin and Akilah Smith are Power 5 players. They could play at very many different schools in the country, and McMakin is showing that so far.
Hilla Jones got fouled on the way up. That was a scary sight to see, because as many NC State fans know, she didn't really play a ton of the NCAA tournament last year, was injured. So this is kind of her first real NCAA tournament. Came down awkwardly after getting fouled there. So good to see her back to her feet.
She's a glue player for this team, another fifth-year senior. NC State starts three fifth-year seniors in Reyna Perez, Kai Crutchfield, and Kayla Jones. They all came back and used their COVID year because of the disappointing finish they had in the NCAA tournament last season. Kayla Jones was injured in their first game, and they weren't able to get out of the Sweet 16 without her.
Second most games in NC State history, Kayla Jones. Back the other way, Longwood trailing by two in the early going here. Knocked away by Kayla Jones. Scrum for it on the floor, able to get it out to Crutchfield. Ja'Kia Brown-Turner on the wing, back to Crutchfield. Over to Perez. This is an NC State team that can shoot and make a ton of threes. They can also do that. The balance between three-point shots and Alisa Kinane underneath makes this team deadly.
That's just beautiful basketball, excellent passing around the perimeter. Kinane was able to hold her position, and she was calling for that thing. Give me the rock and let me go to work.
Kinane 4 points already here in the first quarter. Averages 14 a game. McMakin, tough shot, almost got the roll. Kinane brings in the... KJ. Thought about going to work on the post, kicks it out. KJ back in the paint, great pass.
They move the ball so well. This team is incredibly unselfish. Kinane only averages 14 points per game because they get everyone involved often. NC State off to a great start here in front of a packed Reynolds Coliseum. Well, they love Alisa Kinane here in Reynolds Coliseum, and she is fighting for position inside against Bree Johns. Her teammates do a good job of looking for her. Look at her. She's watching the ball, following the ball, catches, and goes right to the rim for the finish.
Alisa Kinane, our today's difference maker, brought to you by CarMax. Big smile. Alisa Kinane earning that nickname, and rightfully so. Program leader in a lot of things, free throws. Second team All-American this year. Well, it's going to be one of the top picks in the WNBA draft coming up, but her legacy inside this gymnasium, inside Reynolds Coliseum, cannot be underscored enough.
100%, Sam. And in the last four games for NC State, the Virginia Tech season-ending regular season final game and the ACC tournament, Alisa Kinane has entered beast mode, All-American mode is what I'm calling it. Her numbers are absolutely ridiculous in the last four. She's been more aggressive. She's looked to score early. There's a different look in her eyes. She wants to take NC State to the Final Four and beyond in her final, what we believe to be her final season here in Reynolds. She does have a COVID year. We'll see if she takes it, but many think it might be her final year.
Foul in the open floor goes against Tredasia Smith. 11 to 5 here in the early going. NC State 4 for 5 to start from the floor. Perez back to Crutchfield, into Kinane. Great ball movement from the pack, and Perez caps it off with a three. She's got 7 now.
Watching NC State play offense, the way they share the ball, the way they move without the basketball, it's quite enjoyable, Sam, to have this front row seat to watch that ball movement. I'll take that any day.
Akilla Smith, again, 32 points in the first four matchup. Might be a little bit tougher going in there this game.
The best teams are unselfish. The best teams move without the ball, and the best teams don't care who scores. And that's what NC State has done here in this first quarter.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. Good look at Reynolds Coliseum there. It was the largest arena in the Southeast when its doors opened back in 1949. The Stones also performed in front of 14,000 fans in Reynolds Coliseum during their American tour. Of course, can't forget Kay Yao became the first full-time women's college basketball coach in the state of North Carolina when she was hired back in 1974. Jimmy V, of course, remember Debbie Antonelli, our great friend, Hall of Famer.
Shout out, Deb.
NC State forward. And President Barack Obama, three U.S. presidents have visited Reynolds. So a lot of history, and more history continues to be built here in the Reynolds Coliseum. Lisa Kinane certainly could have her name up in the rafters here momentarily.
She will. I'm not on the committee. I'm not on the Wolfpack Hall of Fame committee. But if it's up to me, Lisa Kinane's jersey is going up in that rafters.
15-5. It's a 9-0 run for the Wolfpack over the last two and a half. Again, first time that Longwood has been the NCAA tournament in program history. Picked up their first ever program NCAA tournament win in the first four matchup. Foul goes against Kayla Jones, her first.
We were wondering how NC State would guard Akilah Smith, who had 32 points in the first four games. And I thought it would be a mixture of Kayla Jones and Jada Boyd. Kayla Jones has done a really good job on her so far. Jada Boyd, first player off the bench for NC State, now gets the pleasure, if you will, not necessarily a pleasure, of guarding Akilah Smith.
Smith fouled on the way up. She has the length, she has the height. Lancers averaging 72 points on the season, but really been the stretch of the last month and a half or so. They're averaging about 78 points a game. Jada Boyd whistled for her first foul, and Akilah Smith, the Big South Player of the Year, will go to the line to shoot two. Connects on the first, she shoots about 75% from the stripe.
She's a very good free throw shooter, part of what makes her very difficult to guard. And she is undersized, but she has quickness. She's very elusive, and that's what she's going to have to use against Kayla Jones and Jada Boyd when they're guarding her.
A little full court pressure from Longwood here. Raina Perez already with 7 points in the game. Kinane with five. Kinane into the post, kicks it out to the corner. On the drive, Ja'Kia Brown-Turner up and in for two. And she collects her first points of the game.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner has played really well in NCAA tournament games as a part of the pack, averaging 13 points per game in the postseason.
Bank is open for Tredasia Smith. Third leading scorer on the team on the other end, 11 points a game. Gets the Lancers back within seven.
Doesn't matter how it goes in, Sam, as long as it goes in. Much needed three for Longwood.
Jada Boyd, double teamed. Turns it over. Kyla McMakin back the other way for Longwood. Skip pass all the way over. Tredasia Smith, another three, this time a bit too strong. And Raina Perez looks ahead to push. Jada Boyd now pulls up. Falls short, races for the rebound, and it's Brooke Anya who brings it up. Smith slows it up for a second, didn't have numbers. Take another one. Couple of threes for Tredasia Smith in the game. And it's now a four-point game.
They call her Day-Day Smith. Have a day, Day-Day. What a start. Two threes for the senior point guard for the Lancers.
Big South Tournament MVP was Tredasia Smith, known for really dishing the ball out, but she can score it as well. That three, no good. And Akilah Smith brings in the rebound. Couple of Longwood fans getting into it here in Reynolds.
This Longwood team, it's been a pleasure to cover them. They are not afraid. They are not afraid at all. They are a very confident team and a veteran team. And NC State punched them early. Longwood has punched back.
8-0 run ended by Kinane there. A little bit slow back in transition defense, and Kinane took advantage. But still, it's not too many teams that can put an 8-0 run on NC State. Kadeja Smith follows it up. Ball in the air. McMakin races to it. Fresh 20 on the shot clock. To the free throw line. Off balance shot. And Ja'Kia Brown-Turner with the board. Kinane falling away off to the right.
I'm somewhat surprised they aren't doubling Kinane more. Most of the time she does go to the rim. She's not big with the fadeaway hook. You don't see that much from Kinane. She's been very good and she's gotten good position near the rim. I would have expected to see more of a double from Longwood, but hey, they're down four. They're still very much in this thing without truly doubling Kinane.
McMakin barely gets open, misses everything out of bounds, NC State basketball. A couple of substitutions for both sides here as Emil Hobby, the 6'1 junior from Jacksonville, Florida, will check into the game for NC State. Head coach Rebecca Tillett for Longwood took over this program March of 2018. In her first year, Kelly, the Lancers went 3-27. They have now found themselves with a 22-win season. And what a turnaround with Rebecca Tillett at the helm.
She is an up-and-coming young coach in women's hoop. She's done a very, very good job with Longwood.
Too many steps. Third turnover of the game for NC State here in the first quarter.
Can we also mention Coach Tillett's white suit? That is a power suit if I've ever seen one. Some Olivia Pope action with that suit.
NCAA tournament, got to bring out the best. Kadeja Smith open, too strong. Adriana Shipp with the follow, in and out, unlucky there. 20 seconds left to go, 4-point game. Guy Crutchfield looks to the sideline, gets the play from head coach Wes Moore. Under 10. Crutchfield looking for help. Finds Ja'Kia Brown-Turner for three off the back iron. And McMakin gets fouled, I think, before the buzzer. Well, foul was called as the clock hit zero. But that will be the first quarter. NC State with just a 4-point lead over Longwood. The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? All right, welcome back. So Kai Crutchfield did commit a foul with 0.2 seconds left to go before we went to break at the end of the first quarter. Now we officially do have the end of the first quarter. NC State with a 4-point lead over Longwood. So Longwood ended the quarter on an 8-2 run. As we welcome you courtside alongside Kelly Gramlich, I'm Sam Ravitch. Great to have you with us here today. You got 1-for-16. Longwood came out and really struggled to find their offense, but they finished the first quarter really strong, Kelly.
I'm very impressed with Longwood, and we saw them against Mount St. Mary's. We know this team is really a good 16 seed, okay? Longwood can play, but generally when NC State punches you in the mouth, most teams fold. Longwood did not. They came back, and they were able to settle in, go on an 8-0 run, as you mentioned, Sam. Longwood's in this game at this first quarter break, and I feel like this helps Longwood that we've had these two weird breaks because of the call with the foul. It helps that to just hang around and get this crowd to feel a little more uncomfortable.
All right, so NC State, a number one seed for the second consecutive season. They also won the regular season ACC title. They won the ACC championship. It's been an impressive year, Kelly, for this team. The question is, what's the ceiling for this year's NC State team?
I think the ceiling is a national championship. This is a team that can definitely win the national championship if they keep playing like they have this year. But Wes Moore has told us they're going to take it one step at a time. And that's what they did this season. They won the ACC regular season. They won the ACC tournament. They got their one seed. And now they're just trying to beat Longwood and move on to the next round.
Three consecutive ACC titles. However, they have 27 NCAA appearances without a title. Only Iowa and Georgia have more. So, you know, there's definitely a ton of pressure. They will take on Kansas State on Monday, who we just saw moments ago take down Washington State. Ayoka Lee was fantastic in the game. Ended up with 20, started slow, but ended up with her 20th double-double of the season, which breaks her own record of a single season high.
She's one of the best players in the country. She's absolutely spectacular to watch at 6'6". She had a 61-point game earlier in the year, which set an NCAA record for most points in a game. And Ayoka Lee is a player to watch, and I'm glad she's still in the NCAA tournament so we can keep watching her.
If NC State is able to hold on and win this game, Elisa Kanane and Ayoka Lee will be a fantastic battle underneath, Kelly.
Big if, because of how Longwood is playing, but you're exactly right. That is a matchup of two second-team AP All-Americans, two of the absolute best players in the game, and they play the same position. So it's truly a head-to-head matchup if we get that on Monday.
So Kanane will start the second quarter on the bench. 7 points, 2 for 3 from the floor, 4 boards. Camille Hobby into the game. Diamond Johnson as well off the bench, one of the best players off the bench in all of college basketball this year. All ACC honorable mention, averages 11 points a game.
She's the sixth player of the year in the ACC. Jada Boyd, who comes off the bench for NC State, was the sixth player of the year last year in the ACC. I've heard Diamond Johnson described not just as a spark off the bench, but a bonfire off the bench with what she can do offensively.
Here's Akilah Smith backing down Jada Boyd. Left hand, no good. Offensive rebound. Adriana Shipp kicks it back out for Deja Smith. Adriana Shipp from way downtown, too strong. Tipped over to Diamond Johnson. 2-on-2 for NC State. Diamond across the court. Ja'Kia Brown Turner on the floor now. Neil Hobby fading away. Difficult shot there. Brooke Anya with the board.
With Kanane out right now, this is a time where Longwood needs to make a run. If they truly want to hang around and be in this thing at halftime, you have to take advantage of when the All-American is on the bench getting a rest.
That shot blocked by Kai Crutchfield. . 21-15, under 8.5 to go. Diamond Johnson for three off the back of the rim. And for Deja Smith, quickly up the floor, finds McMakin off of 1 foot. Kyla McMakin has 7 points in the game.
Have we seen McMakin shoot off of 2 feet?
That's a great question.
She loves the 1 foot, maybe the Dirk effect from back when, and now you see players like Luka Doncic always shooting off of 1 foot. I'm sure McMakin watched that growing up.
Camille Hobby's shot blocked by Akilah Smith. Akilah Smith, back-to-back Defensive Player of the Year awards in the Big South. And a foul as Camille Hobby was trying to break through there.
This is such a crafty play by Kyla McMakin. Longwood's leading scorer, averages 18 points per game. She catches it, stops, and pops off of 1 foot. High level of difficulty, but realizing that she was going up against Camille Hobby, who has size on her, might as well stop and pop before Hobby was set defensively.
So a 4-point game here in the second quarter between the 16 seed and the 1 seed. NC State shooting 50% from the floor, but yet Elisa Kanane remains on the bench. Backdoor cut. Jada Boyd finishes it off at the net. Her first points of the game.
And this just shows how much faith Wes Moore has in his bench. Hobby and Boyd and Johnson, who have been so good for Coach Moore. He didn't panic. He didn't put Elisa Kanaan back in when Longwood went on a run because he trusts Camille Hobby and he trusts those three that he brings off of the bench.
Longwood has taken a ton of threes. They're 3 for 11. This time, Tredasia Smith to the hole. A lot of contact there. No whistle. And now we do get a whistle. Foul goes against Ja'Kia Brown Turner.
Camille Hobby with excellent vision out of the post. She sees that number 4 was lost, and she looks for her teammate. Jada Boyd also realized that Kennedy Calhoun didn't know where she was. Cut behind her. Easy bucket for the Pack.
Ball out underneath for the Lancers. 22-11 this year. Big South tournament champions. Akilah Smith from the mid-range. 6 points. For Akilah.
This Longwood team is impressive. I'm not questioning anything because I know it's a hard job, but I'm really not sure how this team's a 16 seed. They look better than a 16 seed.
Diamond Johnson, too many steps, 4th turnover of the game for NC State.
Akilah Smith knows that she's a bit undersized in this matchup, so if they give her the mid-range, she's gonna take it, and she definitely has that in her arsenal.
Johns with the ball. Tredasia Smith trying to call for a screen. Hands it off to Akilah Smith, under 10 to shoot. Akilah drives baseline, difficult shot. And the rebound to Kayla Jones, quickly up the floor, numbers, bounce pass to Diamond Johnson, offensive foul on Kayla Jones. That's her 2nd.
You could see that call coming from a mile away. Kayla Jones has to be able to put the brakes on a little better. And again, because I've talked about this before, because Day-Day Smith is the primary defender on Kayla Jones, the semicircle does not matter. As long as you're the primary defender, it doesn't matter. And she was able to set her feet. Kayla Jones had to put the brakes on, saying you gotta stop and be able to make that pass before you run over the defender.
Kanaan back in the game. Kelly, what have you seen from Longwood defensively that's made it so tough for NC State to get into a rhythm today?
Well, I think with Kanaan out, they were able to do some damage, but they've been very active. They're undersized, as we've talked about, but they've been very active on the ball. I think what I'm most impressed with is what they're doing offensively, how they're keeping up. And I like the game plan. They're still trying to get the ball to Akilah Smith and let her work, but they're also taking a lot of threes. They've taken 11 threes. They've made 3 of them. That means you can get a good look. You get the ball on the rim and try to get an offensive board, but Coach Tillett is very aware they're going to have to make some threes in order to stay in this game, and they've done that so far.
Out of bounds will go NC State's way. Yeah, you look at the rebounding column, 5 offensive rebounds for Longwood as opposed to 1 for NC State. So they're getting some second chance opportunities.
That is actually probably the most impressive thing, Sam, is how Longwood is hanging out in the rebounding battle. Because we know Wes Moore is a huge rebounding coach.
Skip pass to Kai Crutchfield. Her 3 is no good. NC State 1 for 5 from long range here in the first half. Bree Johns for 3, no good.
Great rebound by Diamond Johnson. Good box out.
Into Kanaan. Immediately double team. Spins out of it though. Gets her own rebound. And gets fouled. So, number 16 Longwood trails by just 4 points with under 5 left to go here in the 2nd quarter. The NCAA Women's Championship is brought to you by Wingstop, where flavor gets its wings. Welcome back, Reynolds Coliseum, the number 1 seed in the Bridgeport region, NC State, with just a 4-point lead over Longwood, with under 5 left to go in the 2nd quarter. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship 2nd round coverage continues today on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on tournament games, times, listings, go to NCAA.com. So Lisa Panay knocks down her first free throw. Fouled right before the break. And makes her second. So Panay's got 9 points to lead the way for the Pack.
The free throw line is another big part of what makes Elisa Kunain so good. She's shooting 83% from the free throw line. That is very impressive for a center. She's the only center in the country shooting 50% from the field, 40% from three, and over 80% from the free throw line. And just the sixth in the last 20 years to do that, Sam. That is unbelievable.
Whistled for the foul there. That's her first.
And here are the other centers who have done what Kunain is doing this year in the last 20 seasons, 50, 40, 80. Kunain is just the second player in Power 5 to do it in the last 20 seasons. That is rare air for Elisa Kunain.
Kunain repeated her performance as the ACC Tournament MVP this season, despite suffering that ankle injury in the final against Miami. Actually came back into the game in the fourth quarter to finish it out. Diamond Johnson, corner three, cash!
Diamond Johnson was a big-time recruit, transferred in from Rutgers this season, and is another one of those no-ego players that Wes Moore recruits. She came from averaging nearly 20 points per game at Rutgers to coming off the bench at NC State because she wants to win.
Raina Perez, spin on the block, and gets a friendly roll inside Reynolds.
Is there a smoother player in women's hoops than Raina Perez? Whew.
...7-0 run for the Pack over the last minute 15. Elisa Kunain fighting for position, immediately double team. Pass, extra pass. Diamond Johnson off to the left. Keela Smith with the board.
If I have one criticism of NC State in this first half, it could be a few things defensively, but sometimes they make one too many passes because they are so unselfish. I would have liked to see Jada Boyd take that shot.
Johnson's shot falls short. And back-to-back turnovers for Longwood. Kai Crutchfield now. Gets the free throw line. Don't know if Kunain was expecting it. Got fouled on the way up.
The sixth player of the year in the ACC can light it up from beyond the arc. Great ball movement. And then Raina Perez. So silky smooth. Stop, spin, pop, make some pay.
Eight different players have led the Pack in scoring this year. Kind of goes to tell you the balance of this team. They can hurt you from the outside. We know that. They shoot 37% from beyond the arc. And of course, Elisa Kunain can hurt you on the inside. So they are a really well-balanced team.
Their roster is well-constructed. Every player fits almost perfectly, even with Diamond Johnson when you bring her off the bench and you're playing two point guards in Perez and Johnson. Both of those players, because they can score it at a high level, can go off ball, and it's not even a big switch for either of them.
Bacon's three off to the right. Largest lead of the game, NC State 32, Longwood 19. Coming up at the half, Degree in the studio with our friends Elle, Rebecca, and Nikki. We got plays from today, and Aaliyah Boston, her historic, and I mean historic, streak in South Carolina. Coming up in just over 2 minutes from now on ESPN. Kunain out to Perez for three. Nylon! Raina Perez, 12 points in the first half.
Make it Raina. That's what we're seeing from number two in white.
You just had to throw it in. 12-0 run. And the Wolfpack fans and crowd have come alive here inside Reynolds Coliseum.
Reyna Perez has not missed a shot today. She is 5 for 5 from the field. She is 2 for 2 from beyond the arc. There was a look in her eye when she made that first bucket, Sam. You could tell, okay, this is my last run. Reyna Perez is a fifth-year senior. We know for sure this is her last season. This is my last chance to play my first game of an NCAA tournament. I'm going to go out here and make the most of it. You've seen that from Perez so far.
And so Wes Moore, the head coach for NC State, shared with us that his neighbor, Ron, constructed a step, literally one step, so that it reminds the team that they have to take one step at a time, one game at a time. It's very literal, but it makes sense, right?
Well, shout out to neighbor Ron, first of all. We've heard he may be in attendance on Monday if the Pack wins, so we'll have to find Ron.
Yep.
He's quite the woodworker. And this is so Wes Moore. Wes Moore, he's just a lovable kind of Southern coach. He has these crazy Southern sayings he throws out there. If NC State gets an ugly win, he says, well, it may be an ugly baby, but it's our baby. That's just Wes Moore. And he may be a cheesy at some times, but he knows it. And that's his thing. And he loves his players.
Offensive foul on Elisa Kinane. That's her second.
They called Elisa Kinane here for that offensive foul, and that's the elbow that hit McMakin. It's a good call there for an offensive foul.
So Longwood trying to end a 12-0 run that the Pack has sprung here in the second quarter. Kyla McMakin turns it over. That has been an issue for Longwood. 4 turnovers in the last 4 minutes. Johnson, top of the key. Might have elevated a little bit there. No travel call. Jada Boyd on the follow. Gets it to go. Milu Venema, number 2 into the game for Longwood. McMakin off the mark again, was 4 for 5 in the first 4 matchup against the Mount. Has struggled 1 for 5 now from distance for Kayla McMakin. Kyla, excuse me.
That was a good foul call. A hook and hold down low.
Diamond Johnson, hesitation, looks up, finds Perez. Back to Diamond Johnson. I'll tell you what, Kelly, those two are just so smooth, and they're like on the same page on every play.
They are in sync because they're both point guards. They know what the other one wants. They see the floor so well. And what a luxury for Wes Moore to be able to play them together at the same time.
Venema picks up the offensive rebound. Tredasia Smith on the step through, somehow gets it to go. Tredasia Smith has 8 points now.
Impressive move from Tredasia Smith. She's been the most consistent so far for Longwood.
5 seconds to shoot here in the second quarter. Perez has been perfect. 6 for 6 from the floor for Reyna Perez. And the NC State Wolfpack end the first half on a 19-2 run. Go in the locker room, 42-21. Wow. The Sea of Red has come alive here inside Reynolds Coliseum. Time now for the halftime report. Throw it over to our friends Elle, Rebecca, and Nikki. Guys.
Let's talk a little bit of NC State. We talked before the tip, right, that the two things NC State had working for them, among other things, was experience and momentum. Is that what keyed them when that game was a little tighter than we anticipated in the first?
It was. And when you think about the experience, think about the experience of Perez, her ability to score the basketball, and she didn't miss a basket or miss any baskets in this game so far. And then the play of Johnson in the second quarter, that's when they really did separate themselves.
NC State tightened up their defense in the second quarter as well, holding Longwood to only 6 points in that quarter. NC State was really efficient throughout the entire first half. It's just that Longwood had more possession possessions. They got to the offensive glass. They turned NC State over at times. So they got more looks at the basket, able to keep it tight in the first quarter. That wasn't the case in the second.
An incredible run, 19-2 run to end the first half, largely why they've got a 19-point lead. We are going to get you second half action from NC State Longwood coming up. And Jeff, if you could have seen the look on our face when this thing was tight, we were just a series of emoji eyes. Like, are the Lancers going to do this? Right now, NC State in firm control.
In the Studio is presented by Degree. It won't let you down. Welcome back to Degree in the Studio.
We had a battle of the states a little earlier on in first round action, an 8-9 matchup between Kansas State, Washington State. And this one was back and forth. Not exactly the most beautiful game offensively, but what'd you see from Kansas State here?
Well, it was going to be back and forth, but you saw a team that has a player that is dominant in the post by the name of Ayoka Lee. You have to get her touches, and when she's able to get those touches, she was able to deliver. She scored 20 points, had 15 rebounds, and then Kansas State, you know what they did? They dialed up their defense, holding Washington State to 40 points.
Kansas State wins 50-40. NC State, the winner of the NC State Longwood game, will face Kansas State. Let's take a look at UConn finally tipping off their tournament action. Listen, we knew this was going to be an emphatic win, right? They tend to do that in the first round. But what did you see from UConn in their first tournament action, Rebecca?
Well, they looked on point from the beginning of this game, both offensively and defensively. They did a great job shooting from three, in particular Beckers and AZ Fudd.
Mercer held scoreless in the third quarter. Defense was incredible. And here we go with UConn doing what they tend to do. Most 40-point wins in the NCAA tournament, more than double any other team. We talked about for Paige Beckers, at least Gino did, that he wanted to see assertiveness and aggressiveness from her. What'd you see from Beckers?
I saw Beckers fill the stat box in multiple areas and multiple categories. Not only did she score, she led the team with 5 assists, and she also rebounded the basketball.
All right, so UConn rolls on. We've got the second half of NC State, the top seed in that Bridgeport region. We will see you on the other side. Thanks for watching Degree in the Studio.
In the Studio is presented by Degree. It won't let you down.
You're watching the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. Back here inside Reynolds Coliseum, the number one seed NC State with a commanding 42-21 lead. As we head to the third quarter, let's take a look at our rewarding performance brought to you by Capital One today, Kelly.
Well, it's got to be Reyna Perez. She played a perfect first half of basketball, was 6-for-6 from the field, 2-for-2 from three, 14 points, was great in the mid-range, 0 turnovers at the point guard spot. As we mentioned, knocked down the three ball. That was an impressive first half from the fifth-year senior.
So it was close. After the first quarter, just a 4-point game. Reyna Perez and company took off in the second quarter and outscored Longwood 23-6. So that is where we are now. Longwood starts it off with a turnover. That was a problem, especially in the second quarter, which led to a lot of NC State's points. Kayla Jones from the elbow. Off the mark, McMakin tried to bring it in, but Ja'Kia Brown-Turner ends up with it instead. Back to Brown, Turner for three, and connects. 5 points in the afternoon for the 6-foot junior out of Maryland.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner grabbed that offensive rebound, kept the play alive, and then was rewarded with an open look for three.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner earned all second team honors at the ACC tournament. Kennedy Calhoun into Akilah Smith. Smith, nice post move, couldn't finish. How about the smallest player on the court getting the offensive rebound, and Kennedy Calhoun, second chance opportunity is no good.
Here's where you may start to see some fatigue with Longwood. That three was short from Kyla McMakin. They played on Thursday, and it was a tough battle. Ended up being a very close game down at the end against Mount St. Mary's. NC State has been resting since they won the ACC championship back on March 6th.
Reyna Perez continues what has been just about as perfect as an afternoon as it can get. 6 for 6, couple of boards, one assist, no turnovers. Takiya Brown Turner, a little heat check here. Tosses up the three to the bench.
That was the exact same spot where she shot the three on the previous possession, and the bench loving it. Three goggles all around, Sam.
8 points for Takiya Brown Turner, 25-2 run. Now for the number one seed in the Bridgeport region, Bree Johns is three. Off the back iron, Raina Perez, a couple of defensive rebounds here to start the third quarter.
She's doing it all. Continues to add to her ridiculous box score.
Jones on the drive.
The floodgates are starting to open. They really did open in the second quarter. This team has so much offensive firepower. They can go on runs that can just bury the opponent.
Rebecca Tillett and Longwood will call a timeout. Like you said, KG, floodgates starting to open. Raina Perez giving it out to Kayla Jones. NC State leads 50-21. Well, the Longwood Lancers set their alarms early this morning, 7:45 a.m. here in Reynolds Coliseum. Rebecca Tillett leading the crew in meditation. Now that looks a little more like sleeping, Kelly. But this is a meditation that Coach Tillett has implemented throughout the course of this season. Part of her routine is to get her team meditating. It's about 10, 15 minutes before they get going for their practices.
They do it before every practice, every game. She is a big believer in mindfulness and in visualization, and they have a guided mindfulness exercise that they do as a team, and it's been a huge part of their turnaround. Coach Tillett has done an incredible job with Longwood. When she took over in her first season, they went 3-27. This year they're 22-11. They went 15-3 in the Big South. Their last 16 games, they've been unbelievable. They blew out everyone at the Big South tournament. They ran through that thing. This is one of the best turnarounds in the sport right now, what Coach Tillett has done at Longwood.
Has to certainly be in recent memory. Just incredible stuff. Back-to-back threes, though, for Bree Johns. Gets a breeze a little life into the Longwood bench now.
Coach Tillett and Akilah Smith and Day-Day Smith, they will tell us that the Longwood bench, they're the people to watch. They go crazy over there for their teammates.
Raina Perez on the drive. First turnover of the game, and a rare one at that.
Sam, she's not perfect. Oh, my goodness.
Heat check. Johns. Oh! Almost three in
almost
a row. Only a 27% shooter from long range. Jones, Kinane on the follow with the left hand. Lisa Kinane, 13 points.
How about 13 points for Kinane on 5 field goal attempts?
Yeah.
Because of how good she's been at the free throw line.
Verdeja Smith, tough angle. This Longwood team does not know the word quit.
They do not. Very tough shot for Tredasia Smith on Kai Crutchfield, who's one of the best defenders in the ACC. Didn't make the all-defensive team, and I really don't know how, because Kai Crutchfield is a shut-down defender, and that's what makes this bucket from Smith even more impressive. The balance that she showed to even get that shot off, much less make it.
So third foul on Alisa Kinane, something to keep an eye on here with NC State in the lead, 52-29. All right, welcome back. Take a look at the bottom half of our bracket here in the Bridgeport region. UConn taking care of Mercer, the 15 seed, 83-38. Now, the number one seed in this Bridgeport region, Kelly, is NC State. Now, it could end up, if everything goes according to plan, big if there, that NC State and UConn would meet in Bridgeport. Bridgeport, Connecticut, that is.
And there have been some discussions about this topic. Wes Moore has made his thoughts known. He didn't love the seeding. He said if you're going to give UConn that home court advantage, you might as well make them the one seed. But NC State has earned the one seed. There's no doubt about it. And UConn has, I think, earned a two seed. It just so happens that these regionals are set beforehand in terms of the location. So Bridgeport, you end up there, you end up with UConn. It's definitely going to be a tall task for NC State if they get to that point to play UConn and to beat UConn in front of a bunch of Connecticut fans in Bridgeport. But I've said this before, NC State can do it. This is a very, very good NC State team. You look at the UConn brand and that's what people get caught up with, but I would not doubt this NC State team and their abilities.
Yeah, they're going to have to try and attempt to end this streak, which is...
But remember, one step at a time.
That's all, right.
We're talking about making a Final Four. Presumably, they would face UConn in the Elite Eight to get to the Final Four. Once you get to the Final Four, all bets are off. You can win a national title. But come on, Sam, you heard Coach Moore. I think he was talking to you, Sam Ravitch,
yeah.
One step at a time.
That's
take
right.
a step on neighbor Ron's step.
Well, look, and the other thing, too, for those who don't know, Bridgeport's at the bottom of the state in Connecticut. Storrs is kind of at the top of the state. It's not as if this is, they're playing in a arena they play in a lot, you know? This is not on campus or the
it's
XL Center.
It's not on campus, but from what I know,
it is close.
Connecticut
I get it.
Is a small state.
I get it, it's close. But
Sam is from Connecticut, so he knows better than me. There will be a ton
there
of UConn
be.
Fans there.
I'm just saying, but on a court that you maybe don't shoot on a lot, the
sure.
sight lines,
not,
stuff like that.
Yeah, it's not in UConn's home gym
right.
on the campus for sure. But it is very close.
No question.
And that will be an advantage, just like it's an advantage for South Carolina, who's the number one overall seed, to be in the Greensboro region to play close to Columbia. But that's an advantage that a number one overall seed should have,
right.
not necessarily a two seed.
All right, Akilah Smith shot off the mark. 55-29. Ja'Kia Brown, Turner's three, short. McMakin quickly up the floor. Again, this was a four-point game after the first quarter break. Keila Smith loses the ball. Ja'Kia Brown, Turner takes it away.
That was a great block by Kunane on the other end. Akilah Smith went from 32 points in the first four games to struggling tonight as Jadeja Smith continues to play well. She has 6 points, 2 for 10 from the floor. Kanane's size, as well as Camille Hobby and the combination of Jones and Boyd, has definitely bothered the Big South Player of the Year.
Into Kanane, who got pushed from behind.
Elisa Kanane can also get it done defensively. This is excellent defense on Akilah Smith, using her size, not fouling, getting a clean block.
Kanane will check to the bench. We've talked a lot about the legacy that she will leave behind. She was not the player of the year this year in the ACC. That went to Liz Kittley at Virginia Tech. And you talked about kind of the way that she has played over the last four games. Whether head coach Wes Moore will say it or not, it looks like and feels like she's playing a bit angrier.
Mm-hmm. She is. She's been more aggressive. You've seen that fire in her eyes. And I can't get anyone at NC State to explicitly tell me that that's the reason.
But that's what your eyes are telling you.
As someone who has been around the ACC and covered this team a lot, I know that Elisa Kanane and Liz Kittley are actually best friends.
Right.
They truly are. They played AAU basketball together. So Kanane, being the classy young woman that she is definitely happy for her friend, but she's also a competitor. And she thinks she's the best player in the ACC. And the last couple games, and you could argue all year, she has looked like one of or the best. And it's a great problem to have if you're at the Atlantic Coast Conference. Liz Kittley and Elisa Kanane are two of the best players in the country, and they happen to play in the same league. And Liz Kittley's numbers were so good this year, it was hard to deny it, even though Kanane did prove herself,
right.
as she did almost every night, but by winning back-to-back ACC tournament MVPs.
See a couple ACC ranks there, 14 points a game this year, 8 rebounds a game. Over 50% from the floor, has also kind of added that three-point shot.
Well, and I think it's telling that we're showing her on the bench, because that's part of why her numbers, 14 points per game, it's not what Kittley was averaging, but that's because NC State won a lot of games this year handedly, right, and didn't need to play Kunane as much as Virginia Tech needed to play Kittley. But part of me was hoping they could win co-player of the year because they were both that good.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner having herself an afternoon. That's the third three that she has connected on.
JBT from three. When she is shooting the ball well at that three spot on the floor for NC State, it takes them to another level.
Kyla McMakin showing off the handles a little bit. And Hamilton Leroy, short corner.
And Hamilton Leroy.
Junior out of Senex, South Carolina. Brown Turner wanted it. Jada Boyd ran into there. Out of bounds, a couple of substitutions will check in. Deja Smith back into the game. As well as Isaiah James, the freshman from Virginia Beach, appearing for the first time. Talented freshman at that. She's going to be a name a lot of people are going to learn in the next couple of years in the ACC.
She is next up for NC State. This team is going to lose a lot. That's why this NCAA tournament run means so much to them, because most likely they'll lose Kunane. We know that Perez, Crutchfield, right, and Kayla Jones are all graduating and out of eligibility. They can't stay anymore. They're getting kicked out in the best way possible. So some of these younger players, like an Isaiah James, who was on the All-ACC freshman team, are going to have to step up.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of these fans who are in Reynolds Coliseum will miss having Alisa Kinane next year. Again, still possibility, but in the mock draft right now, she goes number five to New York Liberty.
And look at all those players on that list. First of all of them playing in the NCAA tournament. Ole Miss did lose, so Shakira Austin is out, but four of those five players, post players.
Right.
And we talked about this during the Kansas State-Washington State game. The post players in women's hoops right now are off the charts.
Brown Turner from the wing. There's James elevating for the rebound and putting it right back. So, got a delay of game warning there.
Kayla Jones, yeah, grabbed that ball when it came out of the net. The officials didn't love that.
Ja'Kia Brown-Turner with 11 points in the third quarter.
Right now, when you're guarding Tre'Dajah Smith, you have to run her off the three-point line. She has been so good from beyond the arc.
Four threes already made for Tre'Dajah Smith. Be sure to catch the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One on the ESPN Family and Network. Sweet 16, Elite 8 are next weekend, then the Final Four from Minneapolis beginning Friday, April 1st, with games at 7 and 9:30 Eastern on ESPN. All comes down to this, the championship game, Sunday, April 3rd at 8 Eastern on ESPN. There's Kyla McMakin connecting, 12 points now, third three of the afternoon for McMakin.
Longwood is not going away. This team can really shoot the rock as well. And as I mentioned earlier, they're going to have to make threes. Coach Tillett knows that. They're 8 for 24 from three, but they're 5 for 10 in the second half.
James in and out. You just got a glimpse of that shot. Very smooth for Isaiah James. McMakin well off the mark. Strong rebound, though, for Adriana Schiff. Count the basket. A little more life for Longwood here. 20-point game right now. Second foul on Jada Boyd.
I love this Longwood team. I love the joy they play with. The confidence, the passion. And a lot of that comes from Coach Tillett. She's been a lot of fun to cover. You can tell she's empowered her team. They know that she believes in them, and they're going to continue to fight.
And how about the town of Farmville? We know a lot of TVs tuned into this one right now. In Farmville, small town, but very proud basketball town. Offensive rebound, put back from Jada Boyd. 10 points, she's in double figures. Now four players in double figures for NC State this afternoon. 25 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. McMakin fading away from the elbow, rattles it home. 14 points for McMakin.
Two of the big three, Tre'Dajah Smith and McMakin, are really scoring the ball right now.
Who else but Reyna Perez at the buzzer? Gets her to 16 points on the afternoon. 68-47 at the end of the third quarter. 26 points apiece for both sides in that third quarter. We head to the fourth here in Raleigh next.
Earlier today in this gym, Kansas State beat Washington State to advance in the 8-9 game, and Ayoka Lee, one of the best centers in the country, was exceptional. She had 20 points, got off to a slower start for her, but she was great down the stretch. And this is our potential matchup on Monday if NC State were to hold on here. We thank the committee for giving us this potential matchup of two of the best centers in the entire game. Ayoka Lee and Elisa Cunane, both second team AP All-Americans. To watch those two battle it out, if we get the pleasure, Sam, that is going to be must-watch TV on Monday.
No question about it. And I'm curious, you know, kind of what you think. Who does what better? What are the strengths, or the weaknesses on both of those? And I'm sure if NC State does indeed hold on, those will be a couple of our talking points on Monday night.
Well, Cunane is definitely a better shooter, even though Ayoka Lee does shoot it pretty well from the free throw line, but Cunane is elite. And Cunane can step out more and has more range, can also knock down the three. But Ayoka Lee has an inch on Elisa Cunane. She's bigger, she's a little stronger. I think she's going to try to push Cunane around, but that's very tough to do because Cunane has become so tough inside as well. And that's what's going to be fun finding out at practices tomorrow and everything, if NC State advances, what we can decipher about the game plans. Because with Cunane inside, NC State shouldn't have to sandwich Ayoka Lee like Washington State did. So the defensive battle between those two coaches and those two centers is going to be fascinating to watch.
Again, our bracket, winner of this one faces off against K-State. Also got Notre Dame, UMass, Oklahoma, IUPUI as well.
We should mention NC State and Kansas State played earlier in the year.
Correct.
In the preseason NIT. And NC State won that game pretty handedly, so they do have some experience, even though Kansas State has gotten a lot better because they start three true freshmen. They have gotten so much better than they were back in November.
Deja Smith at the free throw line, 16 points so far today, make it 17.
She has been exceptional. What a game for Tre'Dajah Smith. She also has 5 assists to go with her now 18 points.
Averages over 5 a game. Now has over 500 assists in her Longwood career. So it's been a very successful career for Tre'Dajah Smith. Diamond Johnson off the pick and roll there. Off for the shot and connects. 5 players in double figures for NC State.
Diamond Johnson is so difficult to guard in the pick and roll because she has such a quick first step. She can get by you. She can pull up in the mid-range. She can shoot the three. Plus, as a defender, you're having to think, okay, I got to get over the screen. I got to fight through it. If you switch it, she's going to go right past the big. She is a difficult matchup.
James Too strong. Offensive board, the putback and the foul. Shaquia Brown Turner a chance for three.
JBT has come to play in this game. She was second team all ACC tournament, and she's adding on to that today. She's knocked down a couple threes. She's been good on the glass, and she is the fifth. There are five NC State players right now in double figures.
How about this? Somehow ends up with the ball after the miss. Into the corner.
Another rebound for JBT.
Neil Hobby now backing down McMakin, too strong. Neil Hobby, the junior out of Jacksonville, been such a solid player for the Wolfpack off the bench this season.
Camille Hobby plays behind Elisa Cunane, so she doesn't start, but she does get good minutes, and she is an excellent player for State coming off the bench. She could have transferred, you know, she could have gone somewhere and played more minutes, become a starter, but she's so committed to this program, and they have needed her. When Cunane has been in foul trouble at different times throughout the year, Camille Hobby has played some big minutes, and of course, next year as a senior, she will have her chance to shine even more.
Hobby here, ball tipped, Akila Smith got a hand on it. Hobby gets it back, hands to Johnson, just inside the line. Diamond Johnson, they could just hurt you so many different ways.
NC State's depth is what separates them. And has what it's what separated them in ACC play this year, and how they were able to win their first ACC regular season title in so many years. But I think Diamond Johnson specifically, adding her from Rutgers was a big pickup for Westmore, because you have a player who can get her own shot. If the play breaks down, she can break you down off the dribble and go score. And if Cunane's having an off night, or Perez, or JBT, you just have another option and another ball handler where you can rest Perez more at times.
Pass just ahead of Madison Hayes, who has checked into the game for the first time. 21 for the Wolfpack. It's the 10th turnover of the game for NC State. Under 6.5 to go here in the game. An 80-56 lead for the Pack. Looking for their 30th win this season. That would set a new program record. James, oh, what a fake! How pretty was that? Isaiah James showing off the boots.
Introduce yourself, Isaiah James, here on national television. What a play from the freshman. Just misses that one, but wow, that got the Pack faithful out of their seats.
That'll get your attention.
The future looks bright. Isaiah James, just a freshman.
Calhoun blocked from behind by James. McMakin fouled on the way up. Count the basket.
Isaiah James, all ACC freshman team. Faked Kyla McMakin out of her shoes. Woo! One, two, almost faked our cameraman. Our cameraman didn't even know where she was going with the ball. I hope SportsCenter and our friends at SportsCenter are watching. That's a SportsCenter top 10 nominee.
Get SVP on the horn. That was SC top 10 if I've ever seen one.
She fooled me. I thought she was passing it.
And look, just like you back in your days.
Sam, I would have been the player in the corner thinking I was getting the ball. That's where I would have been.
Diamond Johnson, excellent pass to Hobby. Cordasia Smith already has 21 in the game. Misses the three there.
Cordasia Smith is letting it fly. Shot that from the first Y in K Yao court.
Yeah.
And she's playing well.
Longwood has taken 28 threes in this game. They've made nine of them. 5 minutes to go. James picks up the deflection. Backdoor cut by Hayes. Just too far out in front.
We got to see this one again. Freshman Isaiah James juking people left and right. Look at her eyes. They stay forward the whole time. Give me two of those, Isaiah James.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? See the Longwood bench there? That is what Division I athletics is all about, having some fun, enjoying your time, despite what the score may be. And going against the number one seed NC State, that is not an easy task. Kelly Gramlich, Sam Ravitch on hand with you here inside Reynolds Coliseum in Raleigh, North Carolina. NC State, the commanding 82-59 lead over Longwood. But tell you what, Kelly, we talked about the history of this Longwood team. They enjoy playing the game of basketball. A lot of these players we talked to were overlooked, like you said, could have played at D1 programs elsewhere, possibly in Power 5 conferences. But they're here in the NCAA tournament for the first time in program history.
And they have taken full advantage. They won an NCAA tournament game for the first time in school history, as this is their first trip to the NCAA tournament, as you said, Sam, when they beat Mount St. Mary's in the first four. And there are many schools throughout the country who have played NC State who would love to have had an offensive showing like Longwood had today. Longwood has been able to score some points today on one of the very best teams in the country. And they only became a D1 program back in 2007, so they are not that old in terms of their D1 life. And they're already here. And again, absolute credit to Coach Rebecca Tillett and what she's done rebuilding this program.
Tell you what, you and I have been incredibly impressed, not only with the caliber of players, the talent, but off the court, these players, these coaches have all been excellent here at this region in Raleigh. Excellent coaches, players, people overall.
Very personable, giving us the information we need to do our jobs to tell their stories, because that's what we want to do. We want to highlight them and their student athletes and their coaches. And they've enabled us to do that as you and I almost got taken out by a basketball.
I was right here.
You were ready, Sam.
I got you.
You were ready.
I asked you, what if you were to kind of sum up NC State in three words, what would some of those words be? Balance is certainly one of them.
Balance, experience, and then probably Kunane. I think those are the three words I would use, but look at their balance. Five players in double figures. Reyna Perez was excellent in that first half. She had 14 points in the first half. And both Perez and Kunane have been on the bench for the entirety of the fourth quarter. NC State hasn't needed them. They're getting some well-deserved rest. Those two will be rested. Kansas State, on the other hand, had to play all 40 minutes against Washington State. So keep that in mind for Monday's game if NC State were to advance, as it's looking like they will at this point.
Kadeja Smith playing like her team is down by two. That's what you want to see. And as head coach Rebecca Tillett, she's loving it on the sidelines. Deja Smith has been spectacular today. 22 points now in the afternoon. Kyla McMakin also with 19. It has been difficult for Akilah Smith, though, underneath. We talk about the big three for Longwood. Just haven't really had that third in this one.
Akilah Smith, still an exceptional player. We saw what she did against Mount St. Mary when she had 32 points. This was a tough matchup for her, going against Kunane and going against Kayla Jones and Jada Boyd, who are two of the best post defenders in the ACC.
Kickball taken out underneath. And Hamilton Leroy back in for Longwood. 84-61, 3:28 left to go in the game. Camille Hobby, nice post move. Up and in with the right. Hobby with eight.
That's a great move by Camille Hobby. One dribble, fake middle, turn around, kiss it off the glass.
Jadeja Smith is putting together a career night. 25 points.
We told you they call her Day-Day. She is having herself a day. What a performance.
Dennis's Bryant shot is no good. A foul underneath the hoop. Also see Sophie Hart for NC State coming into the game as Camille Hobby will head to the bench.
Sophie Hart, also a freshman along with Isaiah James. There's going to be a big Kunane-sized hole to fill if she does indeed move on. Obviously, Camille Hobby will fill into that role, but they're going to need much more from Sophie Hart, top 65 recruit in the 2021 class.
Genesis Bryant will try again and connect. Genesis Bryant for three. Up and in on the other end for Akilah.
Akilah Smith.
Nine different players have scored for NC State today. Hayes blocked on the drive, but Akilah Smith whistled for the foul. Second foul on Akilah Smith. This is kind of cool, though, Kelly, because I'm not sure how often you're going to see the future, if you will, of NC State on the floor throughout an NCAA tournament season. But you're kind of seeing some of the newer players to this program. But this has always got to be a good feeling, right? You're on the bench having fun with the starters.
The starters are absolutely loving it. And we've been at practice. The crew that's on the floor right now for NC State, they work their butts off in practice as well, just like the starters. Sophie Hart is a freshman. She's having to go up against Elisa Kunane every single day in practice. Isaiah James is having to guard Ja'Kia Brown-Turner in practice. And so they're getting better every day. I saw Sophie Hart battling with Elisa Kunane when we were at practice yesterday. It's only going to help her in her future. And it makes Kunane better, too, when you have such a talented young player that you have to try to go against every single day.
Bree Johns, one of two, 7 points for the sophomore of Alexandria, Virginia. Timmons will pull up. In and out, Hayes with the board, up and in.
What a rebound by Madison Hayes. Almost even with the backboard, and she pulled that thing down.
Over 90 points for the NC State offense. McMakin will dribble it out, 15 on the shot clock.
I know NC State has 90, but as I said before, there are many, many teams that NC State has played this year that would have loved to score nearly 70 points on them, and that's what Longwood has done.
Longwood fans making the trip in their first NCAA tournament appearance in program history. Won their first ever game back on Thursday here inside Reynolds Coliseum against Mount St. Mary's. Then you run into a potential national champion here in NC State. Genesis Bryant on again. James, no good. Kila Smith with a rebound.
We have quite a few other really good games on the ESPN family of networks today. And you can see that those scores at the top of your screen. Tennessee and Buffalo in a tight one at the half. Ohio State and Missouri State in a tight one. We've already seen some upsets. Villanova took down BYU today, another double-digit seed. By my count, four double-digit seeds have already won in this year's women's tournament.
Check out today's player of the game, brought to you by Orgain Protein. Check it out after this shot. NC State fans not happy with the call as Leroy knocks down the first. But who else, Kelly? Reyna Perez was terrific.
14 points in the first half. Did not miss a shot. She missed a shot in the second half, and it was shocking. It was shocking that she missed a shot because she was so good in the first half. Didn't even have to play in this fourth quarter. Reyna Perez, one of the more underrated players in women's hoops, and she needs a little more credit for what she does for NC State on a nightly basis.
All right, so exactly 1 minute left to go. NC State has all but wrapped this thing up. Kelly, I'm curious. Give us a little teaser, just a little taste of what we can see on Monday with a matchup between NC State and Kansas State.
Well, it starts inside. Lisa Kunane and Ayoka Lee, two AP All-Americans, are going to battle it out. What really will decide that game, though, is how Kansas State's supporting cast can step up, because we've talked about it throughout this broadcast. NC State's supporting cast around Elisa Kunane is so good. They go eight deep. They have so many players that can score in double figures. And you've got three freshmen that are relied upon a ton for Kansas State in Serena Sundell and the Glenn twins. So how those freshmen are able to play will be a big factor in that game on Monday.
All smiles from NC State's bench. Five seconds left to go here in this 1v16 matchup. Longwood kept it close. It was just a four-point game after the first quarter.
Longwood has a ton to be proud of. They got the win over Mount St. Mary's. Scored 68 points on NC State. That is not easy to do. Had their best season in school history. We have not seen the last of Coach Tillett and Longwood. I would expect to see him in the big dance next year.
Sophie Hart shot is short, out of bounds. Shot clock is off and a timeout. Becca Tillett calling timeout here. Perez can really do it all for this team. Just a couple assists away from 100 on the season, but today she's a little bit more offensive-minded.
Sam, you can say it. She made it, Reyna. That's what she did. Didn't miss a shot in the first half. 6 for 6 from the field, 2 for 2 from three. Completely in command of the offense. Didn't have a turnover in the first half. And she had the audacity to miss a shot in the second half. Finished 7 for 8. From the field. She is as good of a point guard as they come in the country. She knows when she needs to call her own number. She is, of course, a great distributor as well, gets her teammates involved. A fifth-year player who knows this is her last run in the NCAA tournament, and she wants to make the most of it, and she's off to a good start.
McMakin inbounds, turned over. That should just about do it. Number one seed NC State. A walk away with a victory over 16 Longwood here by a final score of 96-68. Westmore and crew will regroup and tee it right back up on Monday against K-State. In the meantime, that'll do it for us alongside Kelly Gramlich. I'm Sam Ravitch. Coverage will continue here on ESPN. Number 11, Princeton, and number 6, Kentucky.